Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbihi ajmain. Alhamdulillah, we are continuing with our free life coach training program, and now we are talking about mentoring. So we have given you the idea of how you can be a certified PIP life coach, starting with understanding of Islamic motivation, Islamic coaching, Islamic mentoring, and then Islamic counseling. And from then on, you become a very competent person that you can help the ummah at the mosque, at the community center, at the universities, NGO, and so on, to transform the ummah, to become an achieving ummah, a wonderful ummah that can live in Iman, Islam, and Ihsan, in peace and tranquility with all humanity and all goodly creatures in the 21st century. So I have given you the definition of mentoring, and I've given you the idea of what kind of mentoring that we can do in the 21st century, including online mentoring, Facebook, WhatsApp, WeChat, Skype, and so on. And then we have the whole range of one-to-one, from mentoring to group mentoring, and so on. So today I'm going to give you, we go back to the perspective of this deen. This deen is brought by the greatest of all mentor, that is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who mentor his sahabis and the whole group of sahabis, then revolutionized the whole world within his lifetime and within the 100 years after the demise of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Islam covers all the civilized world, and we developed the most civilized civilization in the world, a very balanced holistic civilization which never have been replicated back again. Even when with the downward trend of Islam after the 16th century, we have this industrial revolution and so on, we have a monodimensional civilization that is based on greed, that is based on destruction, that is based on oppression, that is based on addiction and so on. So we never recovered yet. So we can bring this glorious era of a new civilization, because people are getting a lot of tired of this whole thing of just buying, addiction, sex, and things like that. So we are coming to a new era in the 21st century, postmodernism, which can go either the way of destruction or the way of suluk, or the way of goodness, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. So from the perspective of Islamic civilization, we call mentoring al-halaqah, a group gathering, or an usra. We have many usra. As a young man, I used to attend usra, and then we have our naqib, our leader, and then we discuss together, and then the naqib will mentor us. So we have many groups, and then we have meetings on Friday prayer, we have maulid, so we continue with this understanding that when we have a halaqa or an usra, we have this mentor-mentee relationship. So for example, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentored, as I say, many sahabis, and basically the most important center was even while Islam was under oppression, at the house of Al-Arqam, all right, where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentored secretly his core followers of a few people, and they became very strong in so far as being able to bring this deen later on in their life. So the era has been continuous. That means the whole idea of mentorship in Islam has been continuous. We have example in Al-Quran, Surah At-Tawbah, verse 971, which explains that mentor play a very important role in helping needy people, guiding people, and doing good things, and forbidding people from doing evil. That means doing good works and avoiding evil. And in our field of tasawuf, that means we have a lot of this tariqa in the past, and from the time of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the Ahli Sufa, all right, we have the so-called Sufi, all right, or the tasawuf, where this mentoring is very, very deep between the sheikh and his student. But unfortunately, a lot of this so-called tasawuf or Sufi movement, like Sidi Ahmad Zaruk says, even 500 years ago, they have been deviated and become more of self-glorification of the sheikh, or maybe oppressive to the so-called the mentee. So that's why we have to find a better model than that. I'm not saying that you cannot be a Ahli Sufi or tasawuf follower, you can, but make sure you have a good sheikh. But the real sheikh is very difficult to find. But the whole system within the tariqah movement is mentor-mentee relationship. And some of the mentor-mentee relationship can be very, very oppressive, which is not suitable in the 21st century. In the past, maybe, I feel like the servitude to the Sheikh, surrendering completely to the Sheikh, and so on. Well, there are many Muslim scholars who say that is very difficult to implement in the 21st century, and I agree with that view. So I do not follow a specific tariqah or with a Sufi master, but I learn from as many good scholars of the world, and we become their student and learn, not to the level of being a mentee, but at least we have a good relationship. But this mentor-mentee relationship, especially in the field of positive psychology, is what I'm directing my effort for us to be able to train to face the psychological challenges and the trauma and the tribulation of the ummah, especially the young people. I have to repeat, these young people will be lost if we do not hold them closely to our heart and become their mentor. Okay, so in mentoring program has two major components. That means the mentor as the educator, leader, teacher, and the mentee as the student or follower who need guidance. Therefore, this mentoring program will be built on the relationship of developing our iman, our Islam, our ihsan, I've mentioned to you, and how we can then relate towards being a true and sincere servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having a close link with a mentor who can bring us closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then having been able to help others. That means when we are mentored, for example, I'm mentored by my teacher, which I studied for quite a long time, alright, then now it's my turn to mentor young people. But we have different format. In the old days, we don't use internet, we don't use Skype, we don't use many of those other things. We are very traditional in the way that we operate, but the adab is still there. So we must bring back the very deep adab of a mentor and mentee. This is very important, especially with this so-called modern world where people has no adab, people has no virtues, people is just who cares kind of attitude, I don't care. And they just throw things around and so on. So I'm trained in certain ways, which you know, how to put the prayer carpet, how to respect the Quran, how to respect your teachers, how to sit in a majlis, how to so many small things which are actually sunnah, which are actually refinement of your inner characteristic, which you don't get in YouTube. But these are the things that you learn. So as a mentor, then you must be able to bring about this understanding. And remember, when you receive this iman, Islam and ihsan, you have this nur, this light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this light will shine through. So if you can do something through fullness of ikhlas for lillahi ta'ala, Allah will give you that light, Allah will give you the guidance, Allah will give you the ability to then help yourself, your nafs, to become mutmainna, and help others who are in turmoil when they are in the nafs of amara or nafs lawama. Slowly and slowly together, you develop this whole deep joy of being, receiving, and having that peace and tranquility blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world and the hereafter. So this world, we are not denying the world, we are not denying the suffering of the world, but we are trying to bring across this whole idea of living in iman, living in peace, living in the fullness of this deen, living in the joy of this dunya and the joy of akhirah, where we say, Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana, fil akhirati hasana, wa qina azaban nar. Always knowing that we are the sincere servant of Allah and His appointed vicegerent and Khalifa on this earth. We always try to do something good every day, inshallah, striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.